Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 6.1, Problem 2. This is Section 6.1, Problem number 2. It says, suppose a large box of roofing nails spills in the parking lot of Home Depot, and suppose you happen to notice that 234 cars in the parking lot don't have any flat tires, 371 cars have one flat tire, 208 cars have two flat tires, 128 cars have three flat tires, and there are 59 cars with all four tires flat. Construct a probability distribution for the number of flat tires a car will have in that parking lot. So, when you want to have a probability distribution, what you're going to have is a chart with two columns. So let's start that. So we'll have a chart with two columns. The first column we will label as X, and the second column will be P parentheses X for probability of X. Now the first column is going to list every possible outcome of your random variable. The random variable in this problem being how many flat tires on a car. So don't forget to include zero. That's what you're hoping for, that you won't have any flat tires. That's one outcome you can have. One flat tire, two flat tires, three flat tires, and possibly all four tires being flat. So now what we have to do to finish our probability distribution is put the probabilities of each one of the items from the first column in the second column. Now to find these probabilities, what we have to know is how many cars are we talking about altogether? List 234 with no flat tires, etc. So let's add those numbers up. So we had 234 cars that had no flat tire. Then 371 had one flat tire. 208 had two flat tires. 128 had three flat tires. And then 59 didn't have any at all. Now, if you add those numbers up, you can either do it by hand or use your calculator. You'll see that the total comes out to 1,000 very conveniently. So 4 and 1 is 5, 5 and 8 is 13, 13 and 8 is 21, 21 and 9 is 30. So let me put the answer up here. 0, carry the 3. 3 and 3 is 6, 6 and 7 is 13, 13 and 0 is still 13, 13 and 2 is 15, 15 and 5 is 20. 0, carry the 2. 2 plus 2 is 4, 4 and 3 is 7, 7 and 2 is 9, 9 and 1 is 10. 1,000 cars in the parking lot, which is going to make our math easy moving forward. So, given that there's a total of 1,000 cars in the parking lot, and 234 of those 1,000 cars didn't have any flat tires, the probability of having zero flat tires would be 234 over 1,000. Now, if you prefer decimals as your answer, you could really do it in your head. I mean, you could take a calculator and do 234 divided by 1,000, and when you do, you would get a probability of 0.234, or about 23%. Next, the probability of having one flat tire. So if you go back to the question and read it, it will say that 371 cars have one flat tire. So the probability that one tire is flat would be 371. 371 of those cars have one flat tire out of 1,000 altogether, which again can be converted to a decimal very easily. The divide by 1,000, I can do in my head. It'd be 0.371, or about 37% probability. Next, what's the probability that the car would have two flat tires? So, look through the question, see how many have two flat tires. There's 208 cars that have two flat tires. So it'd be 208 over 1,000, because there's 1,000 cars in the parking lot altogether, which you really could leave as a fraction, but if you prefer decimals, it becomes 0.208, or slightly less than a 21% probability. Now, next possible outcome is that a car would have three flat tires. So as you read the paragraph again, you would find that there are 128 cars in that parking lot that have three flat tires. So the probability of having three flat tires is the 128 cars that have three flat tires over the 1,000 cars altogether. which again can be converted to the decimal 0.128, or slightly less than a 13% probability. And finally, what is the probability that you are one of the very unlucky people with all four tires on your car flat? There are 59 cars in the parking lot altogether where all four tires are flat. Out of the 1,000 cars in the parking lot, so it would be 59 over 1,000, which again, you could leave, that is a good probability, or if you like decimals better, it would be 0.059, so almost a 6% probability. So this is the probability distribution for how many flat tires a car might have in that particular parking lot.